Okay, so here's a short demo of the RK-002 together with the Arturia Beatstep Pro. Although Arturia has also updated their firmware so you can play the Volca Sample just from one drum sequencer track, the RK-002 does have some other advantages. I'll show you a few in this video. First, something about the configuration in the Beatstep Pro, which enables you to control the RK-002 parameters. So you don't have to use the web interface, because the Arturia Beatstep Pro and Keystep, they all block system exclusive messages which we use to set the parameters of the RK-002. First, something which is important with the new firmware versions is that the program change message, MIDI program change, is the key to a lot of different play modes on the RK-002. You can use it for simple sample triggering or polyphony, or like I will show you in this video, use the RK-002 to play different melodies on the Volca sample with the Beatstep sequencer. So you just set the program change message under a dial in the control sequencer of the Beatstep Pro. You can vary the range between 0 and 29. These are all the play modes the RK-002 currently accepts. Also, you can set some Volca sample control parameters, like here parameter 42, which is a high cut. You can set it under a dial. And the only solution we could think of to control the parameters on the RK-002 without using system exclusive is NRPN commands. They aren't the easiest commands you can use in MIDI, and also not quite standard, but okay, we just made it so you can do something in the Beatstep Pro without using a external computer. So once you've selected NRPNs on the dial, you can just leave bank MSB parameter to 6, and the LSB, you can set that to the RK-002 parameter. So this one will set the chromatic play bass key. You can change the octave on which the RK-002 responds to chromatic play. If you don't want to use it, you can set it really high or just out of range. Then you can set the MIDI response channel. You have to watch out with this, because if you change the MIDI response channel, the RK-002 won't respond to the next message you'll send to it. So you have to change the bass channel of the Arturia as well. Next one would be velocity mapping parameter. You can also change different Volca sample parameters on velocity and pad velocity. Pitch bend mapping parameter, well, not really useful from the Beatstep Pro because it doesn't have a pitch dial. Modulation map parameter, again, it's not on this device, but you can change the parameter for if you have something else which does support it. And then the sample trigger bass key, it's by default is set to note 36, which is a range available in a lot of keyboards. And then in the device settings, you have to set a custom key mapping on your drum sequencer, starting from note 36 and up. The Volca sample only has 10 channels. There are 16 pads, so I remapped the last 6 pads to some notes in the chromatic range, so you can play a melody on your drum track as well. Okay, now when this is done, let's see how this works. I'll select an empty track on the Beatstep Pro and the Volca sample. And then I set the dial I've programmed with the program change message to 23, which means for the RK-002 to play from its bass response channel and 2 channels up, so 1, 2, 3. Now you set the sequencer of the Beatstep to play from channel 1, 2, and 3, and the other sequencers send out at channel 2 and 3. I put in some old Super Nintendo sounds, the flute, a bell, and some strings. And on the drum track, we have them combined. And as said, the last 6 are tuned in the chromatic range. Now just set a simple beat to have a tempo and start playing. This melody comes from the Volca sample channel 1. And here, when you switch tracks, you can tune Volca sample channel 3. Note that the RK-002 also does note length. It simulates a note off message, although the Volca Sample is a sample trigger device only. And now the third melody on channel 2. And of course you can use all those Beatstep Pro re-trigger effects and stuff.